Good morning. Good morning. Wow, it's great to see so many people here today to enjoy our worship and to enjoy once again the gospel drama put on by our school children. They did a great job Friday night at the auction, which was a wonderful success. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody for your support. We'll have some numbers next Sunday for you, but they're really good numbers, at least the preliminary ones. As I say that, there's still a few items. There's some leftover, they're really not leftover, cupcakes. They were fantastic cupcakes, but there are some still available at the back of church for a free will donation. There also are some gluten-free and dairy-free ones as well, so you can get those. There's a few other items, but then there's three T-ring certificates, you know, that Sandy Schulte makes. So those are also available. So if you get there first, you can buy one of those T-rings. That's also a free will donation. As I say that, this is the last Sunday to sign up for Easter flowers. That's in the back of church as well. See Joanne. And then, of course, as you came into church, the lovely smell of cinnamon rolls came over you. The ladies eight are doing cinnamon rolls and fellowship after our service today. I think that's it. A great day to be in the Lord's house. We will have our order of service will be divine service setting one on our first hymn, 9:15. Today your mercy calls us, 9:15. Blessings as we worship today. Absolution. Let us stand together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Continue as we sing responsibly the intro.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. For I know my transgressions. Against you, you only, have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity. Behold, you delight in truth in the inward being. Mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. Pray to the Lord for the peace from above and for our salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the
Lord.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, your mercies are new every morning. And though we deserve only punishment, you receive us as your children and provide for all our needs of body and soul. Grant that we may heartily acknowledge your merciful goodness, give thanks for all your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
The Old Testament reading for the fourth Sunday in Lent is from Isaiah chapter 12. You will say in that day, I will give thanks to you, O Lord, for though you were angry with me, your anger turned away that you might comfort me. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation, and you will say in that day, give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the peoples, proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be made known in all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, O inhabitant of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Epistle reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. From now on, therefore, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we once regarded Christ according to the flesh, we regard him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. All this is from God, who through Christ reconciled us to himself and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ, God making his appeal through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us stand together as we sing the Lenten verse and hear the gospel. Gospel according to St. Luke, the 15th chapter. Now the tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to Jesus. And the Pharisees and the scribes grumbled, saying, this man receives sinners and eats with them. So he told them this parable. There was a man who had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the share of property that is coming to me. And he divided his property between them. Not many days later, the younger son gathered all he had and took a journey into a far country, and there he squandered his property in reckless living. And when he had spent everything, a severe famine arose in that country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into the fields to feed pigs. And he was longing to be fed with the pods that the pigs ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have more than enough bread, but I perish here with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and felt compassion, and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring the fattened calf and kill it, and let us eat and celebrate. For this my son was dead and is alive. He was lost and is found. And they began to celebrate. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. And he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, your brother has come, and your father has killed the fattened calf because he has received him back safe and sound. But he was angry and refused to go in. His father came out and entreated him, but he answered his father, look, these many years I have served you, and I have never disobeyed your command. Yet you never gave me a young goat that I might celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours came, who has devoured your property with prostitutes, you killed the fattened calf for him. And he said to him, son, You are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. It was fitting to celebrate and be glad, for this your brother was dead and is alive. He was lost and is found. This is the gospel of the Lord. We confess our faith together using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Be seated for our next hymn. What wondrous love is this? 543.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming in on such short notice.
Your message sounded urgent.
Yeah, you made it sound like a matter of life and death. Well, I guess you could say it is. Our advertising agency, BIG, has been given a very important and challenging new assignment, and we need to get started on it right away.
Great. You know our team loves a challenge.
First, let me introduce you to Pastor Stan. He'll tell you exactly what he needs and why he hired us.
Hey, everybody. How you doing? Thanks for being here. I'm giving a message in a few weeks at my church, and it's going to be a doozy. I'm preaching on the Bible.
Isn't that a talk about every week, Pastor?
Well, yeah, I preach on the Bible every week, but this is different. This week, I'm going to talk about the Bible.
Oh, cool. I love coming up with new and creative ways to tell people about Bible stories.
Well, this is a little more than just a single Bible story. I want to preach the entire Bible. All in one morning.
No offense, Pastor, but I don't think anyone wants to listen to a sermon that long. That's our challenge, team. We need to come up with a way for Pastor Stan to tell people the entire Bible in roughly 25 minutes.
Wow, that won't be easy. Maybe we should change our name from the Big Idea Group to the Big Bible Idea Group.
I mean, the Bible has 66 books in it, 1,189 chapters, 31,102 verses. I'm not sure it can be done.
Well, it's a huge task, but that's why Pastor Stan hired us, right?
That's exactly right, Isaiah. I figured if you could handle this giant task, anyone, it's the BIG. I mean, your company's one of the best advertising agencies out there. That initiative you did for World Hunger was incredible. I mean, sometimes kids just know how to say things best. Simple, uncomplicated, straight to the point. That's why I hired you.
Pastor, you've chosen wisely. As the Chief Creative Officer for BIG, let me assure you we'll come up with exactly what you're looking for. Okay, team, let's get started.
Well then, why don't we start at the beginning?
Don't you mean in the beginning?
Huh?
You know, Genesis 1:1, when God created the heavens and the earth?
Yes, that's the perfect start. Our first big Bible idea, the big plan, creation.
Yeah, when I think about how God made the world and everything in it, I'm amazed at how creative he is.
Me too. God must have had a big imagination to come up with some of the stuff he's put on earth, because some of them are a little, shall we say, interesting.
Thank you.
Okay, team, that's great progress. We have the big Bible idea number one, creation. What's next?
If we're going to talk about the high points, we should probably talk about the low points.
I agree. It does seem necessary to the big story of the Bible.
It just sounds like really bad news.
It is bad news, but when you understand the bad news, you realize how truly great the good news is.
Hold on, team. Exactly what bad news are we talking about here? There's quite a few things in the Bible that could fit in the bad category.
You know,
plagues, war, death, and destruction.
That's true, but there's one event that led to all that other bad news.
Yep, that one terrible moment when sin entered the world.
It's hard to understand why Adam and Eve chose to disobey God after he had given them such a perfect place to live.
The one thing he told them not to do was eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and they did it anyway.
And from then on, we would be waiting for someone to come and rescue us from our sins. Boy, I can't wait to get to that part.
This is great progress. We started with creation, and now we have the big choice, catastrophe.
Boy, what a sad, sad day that must have been.
Thank you.
It's sad to think that God created things to be so perfect, and one choice changed everything. Beauty and life became sorrow and death.
But God promised he would rescue his people from the consequences of their sins.
Hey, this is all great, but we've only covered two big events, and we're still in Genesis, the first book of the Bible.
I'm sure Pastor Stan will want us to cover what happened in the rest of the Old Testament. After man sinned, God promised that one day he would make things right.
And in the meantime, there was kings, judges, prophets, sacrifices, and a whole lot of laws that would be impossible to keep.
Basically, for many generations, God showed us how much we needed a Savior.
So they waited for God to answer his promise.
And they waited.
And waited.
Until
Jesus!
The answer to God's promise had finally come.
Still, Jesus wasn't the kind of king people were expecting.
He wasn't what they expected, but in spite of his humble birth, he was God's son, the savior of the world.
And he was perfect, fully human, yet fully God.
I mean, really, how many kings show up as a baby born in a stable?
And how many kings choose to die on a cross? He took the punishment for our sins so that we could have the kind of relationship that God intended for us to have with him way back in the beginning.
Yep, Jesus was the perfect person who would be the perfect sacrifice for all sin for all time.
It sounds like Jesus was the perfect gift.
That's it, the third big idea. We've got the big plan creation, the big choice catastrophe, and now the big gift, a cradle and a cross.
Jesus came as a baby, died on the cross for our sins, and then God raised him from the grave, conquering sin and death once and for all.
I told you that all the bad news would make the good news sound really good. Actually, it's great news.
There's still a lot of the New Testament we haven't covered, though.
Right, all the things Jesus did while he was alive, the miracles, parables, and the people he spent time with.
Plus, we have all the other New Testament books the apostles wrote after they had gone back to heaven.
Yeah, those are all such important parts of the big Bible story. It proves who Jesus was and why he came.
And it helps us know how we should live until Jesus returns.
You know, team, that's the last big event we should address, when Jesus returns to make everything right again.
I think that's what the Bible calls resurrection, when everything that's broken is made new.
That's right. No more sin, and no more death or suffering, and no more sin.
One of the coolest things about this part of the story is how the Bible says Jesus is coming back to reign as king forever, and we will reign with him. So, how about the last part of our big Bible idea is, ta-da, the big finish, a celebration and a crown. Welcome back, Pastor Stan.
We've been working very hard on your big Bible idea.
We think we've come up with something you're going to love. This is the big, big, big story of the Bible. Team, let's show Pastor Stan what we've got.
First, we've got the big plan, creation. That's when God set everything in motion.
Next, the big choice catastrophe. That's when sin entered the world and everything changed.
And then we have the big gift, a cradle and a cross. That's when God gave his greatest gift ever, Jesus.
He came as a baby, lived a perfect life, and fulfilled God's plan by dying on the cross.
Of course, Jesus didn't stay dead. God raised him from him to life. He's still alive today.
And one day we're going to see Jesus again, and he'll reign as king forever and ever, and we'll have this big celebration, and God's going to make all things new, and it'll be awesome.
So yeah, that's it. A big finish and a celebration and a crown.
Thank you, Deshaun. We all appreciate your enthusiasm for this campaign. So, Pastor Stan, what do you think?
I like it. I mean, I really like it. I mean, I love it. It's fantastic. You guys did such a great job. Now, can you send me all the files and everything, the graphics, the logos? We need to get started for the promo right away, and you'll all be there on that Sunday, right? Great. You guys did an awesome job. Thanks for all your help.
Well, team, we did it. Good work. Okay, hands in. Now, what's the big idea?
The big, big, big story of the Bible.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your steadfast love. Give us a proper knowledge of the evil we have done in your sight. Move us to confess our offenses against you and justify us by your holy absolution. Lord, in your mercy. Father in heaven, you welcome us into your family for the sake of your Son. Call us to repentance when we wander from your ways or believe we have earned a place in your household by our works. And return us to the confident joy that in Christ alone we are found and alive. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord God Almighty, that you have made your deeds known among us. Bless our pastors, teachers, musicians, and all church workers in their daily labors to make known your deeds among the peoples. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty God, in Christ, you are reconciling the world to yourself. Watch over our nation and all whom you have placed in authority over us. We pray especially this day for Ukraine and all the events happening there. Give wisdom and prudence that your people might live in peace and freely make known the message of reconciliation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers for all who cry out to you for mercy, healing, and help, especially Verona, Bee, Ashley, Greg, Dwayne, Jim, Steve, Karen, Ray, Pete, Marlene, and Harlan. Deliver them according to your will as you have made them a new creation in Christ. Keep them mindful of the day when sorrow and sickness will be no more. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated now as we gather our offering. Let us stand as we continue with the Lord's Prayer. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Almighty and everlasting God, since you govern and sanctify your whole Christian church by your Holy Spirit, hear our prayers for all her members, and mercifully grant that by your grace we may serve you in true faith. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Be seated for our closing hymn, 725, Children of the Heavenly Father, 725.